Didn't even meet his mom or anything yet, or his mom had. such a calm and humble experience that you just feel for such a sweet animal that need help and is helpless at that moment. Yeah, they took him home. They fed him, and then the mother never came back, so they called wildlife, and wildlife came and got the deer and I guess raised it until they could put him back out in the wildlife. But that was such a cute story that I saw. Okay, so we're gonna do animal smaller than a Labrador. A Labrador is is that a big dog? What is it really? Or maybe is it a small dog? That's why they say animal smaller than a Labrador, because it's so small. What could be smaller than a Labrador? When I think of a Labrador, I think about a big black dog. I don't know why. Speaking of dogs, oh my God, let me tell you another short story today. Another short story. It was so cute. I freaked out. I actually started screaming like a man. Let me get this candy out and I'll tell you about it after I read the words, okay? Sounds are turned down. It is not your microphone. Again, it is not your microphone. The sound was turned down so I can get the candy inside. Here is a hard crinkle container. They just falling out. Sparrow, toad. Alright. Okay, so those are all the animals that are smaller than a Labrador. Alright. I am one happy bee to be here with you today. I am all smiles. Thank you. first one that we're looking for is Ant. This heart is so small. Oh my God. All right, Ant is the first one that we're looking for. Pink has chose us. Today I went walking and Nadine was saying that ants have built like these huge ant hills in the park, and I stepped right on one and she said, oh mom, they're gonna have to start all over again. And I said, well, they'll be done in no time. I know it, they work so fast. See it. I try to look down, but you know, sometimes you listen to music, you get taken away, you know. But the ants, they do, they put so much into the anthill, so I do try to respect it. I felt bad. Then Nadine felt bad. I crushed the anthill. Oh my God, why did I have to do that? I'm a city girl. I'm from North New Jersey, so when he took me to be his family and we was going to a cookout, I never been to like a farm country cookout. It was shocking, okay? I was so excited. They told me that we was gonna have some good chicken on the grill. I could not wait to get me some chicken. I was not playing. We got a little chicken. right here. I couldn't wait to get some chicken. And I asked my husband what's taking him so long to put chicken on the grill. He said, oh, so upset, and him and his family cracked up laughing because I was horrified. They thought that was so funny, and it was like, when we eat chicken, this is what we do, you know. Oh, the next word is crab. This is what we do, we catch our own chicken. I was so done with him and his family. Oh my god, I asked him why didn't he like prepare me for that. I was all excited about being on a farm, not thinking that the food that we eat would be the ones that, you know, the food, I can't even get out, the animals that they raise on a farm, and chow was all the pieces. I wasn't no good. I was no good. Crab. Okay. That is like my favorite thing. I didn't see crab as an animal. I saw, I don't know, well, I guess it is, well, I saw crab more of like fish, like seafood, not more like an animal. But is crab an animal? Oh my god. Well, so do they consider, I guess crab can be an animal because it breathe on land, right? Is that why they call it an animal? Crab, C-R, that shouldn't be too hard, C-R. CR, where is it? Now, I had me some crabs today. I'm telling you, after I had crab, I don't know why, every time I eat crab, I get so freaking sleepy. I went to bed. It was like middle of the day, and I went to bed. I was not here for it anymore. I was just so sleepy. Crab. CR. It out. That's why I can't find it, because I don't cross it out and I didn't even find it yet. That's like counting your eggs before they hatch and then they never hatch because you didn't give them the time to hatch. You already counting them before you even got them to see which one's going to be here. Crab. C-R. Okay, where is it? black eyes been in front of my face the whole time. The next one is Crow. I saw a crow today. Oh my God, just did it again. Crossed it out again. I can't believe it's wrong with me. I saw a crow today bullying another bird. It was such a cute little tweaky tweet bird like this. So cute and little. And the crow was bullying it. You better go right now. And then we started screaming, the bird went flying away. So, my God, why you do that to that cute little birdie? Very. Okay. Oh, man, I gotta wait on the story that I was gonna tell you. Don't let me forget about the dog, okay? Very. F-E-R-R-E-T. Let's find that one. She was saying, I cleaned my room, but I hope it don't stink. And the whole time I was holding my breath when I was in her room. And she said, do it stink? And I was like, oh God, now I gotta let my breath out just to answer. So I would be like, then, no. Holding my breath again. And she's like, oh, okay, because I really cleaned my room today. Oh my God. I have no words to tell you, but she loved that freaking ferret. It'd be on her neck, on her arms, and in her bed, and underneath the bed. It'd just be all over the place. One time, she took the ferret to the park with us. I was like, okay, am I supposed to help her fight another animal over that ferret? Because I was slightly afraid for the ferret. I don't know why she took him to the park, but she would. She'd bring the whole cage and then let the ferret out. And I was saying, my friend name was Felicia. I would say, Felicia, you don't see the ferret as a dog, do you? No, but he loves the park. I said, oh, okay. So the next one is Frog, which I'm not happy about that one. So we're gonna find that one. I know a lot of people love frogs. I don't have nothing personally against frogs, but frogs is somehow or another a part of my life, attached in my life somewhere, and the frog means love, you know, when you see one. I think it means change. I have experiences that every time I saw a frog, something happened in my life. Like my OGs, they know every time I see a frog, I freaked out because, like a frog, I had a frog waiting on me at my front door. He wouldn't leave. And I literally had to jump over him to get to my house. I was freaked out. I was out there in the rain for a long time, getting soaking wet. And my kids was cracking up laughing, seeing mom just step over the frog. You know, he's not leaving. He's not going to do anything. But I couldn't see myself. All I could think about, if I step over this frog and he hop on me, I'm going to literally die right here. I am going to pass out and I'm not coming back. So I was scared. So my neighbors was all out in their window watching me get soaking wet. And the rain wasn't like drip, drip, drip. It was like just dropping on me. I was soaking wet, y'all. I finally had to go over the frog to get in the house. I was so freaking scared out my mind. And then later on that night, I went to go take a shower, okay? And while I'm in the shower, I'm feeling relaxed. I'm feeling happy to be in the house. We look up a gerbil. And that what it is. Oh, this is so cute. It is a cat right here. I think it's a little, see, that look like a tiger. This is a cat right here. So cute. Gerbil. Let's see if we see anything that like a gerbil up here. What, a gerbil is like a little hamster, right? I don't know. It look like a hamster. I don't see a gerbil up here. Son hit me. I realized that he hit me. So then I just started, I was like, a frog, a frog, a frog, a frog, a frog, a frog. And my son was like, where, where, where? And I was pointing to my leg. But when he looked down, it was nothing there. So when I looked down, it wasn't there. And I was just like, screaming again, screaming again. And my son went running in the bathroom to see if it was in the bathroom. And guess what? It was in the bathroom. It was an adult, huge frog. My son found it. He's like, oh my God, this frog is huge. My life began to change. And right when that happened, a couple of days later, I had a huge change in my life. So I'm talking from experience, okay? Hamster. Hamster, H-A-M-S-T-R. I don't see no hamster. Oh, they got a cute little deer. What I was telling y'all about this earlier. Let's put him right here. He's so cute. Oh dear. Well, I don't see a hamster. H-A-M-S-T-R. Now, my daughter wanted a hamster, my oldest daughter, when she was little. But instead of a hamster, I got her a goldfish because I was afraid. I was afraid that a hamster gave me the weepy jeepies. It reminds me so much of a, I'ma say, mouse. So she was upset. I almost feel like she holds it against me for the rest of her life that I didn't get a hamster. She was so furious with me. Oh, they got hair, a rabbit. Isn't a hare a rabbit the same thing, I would think? Let's use this one. A hare. It's white. It's white and cute. Oh, it's so cute. You're so cute. Oh, there you go, right there. Rabbits are so cute. I don't eat rabbit. And one reason why I don't eat rabbit is because my mom had bought us a rabbit when I was a little girl. And I was the one responsible for taking care of it. I love that rabbit. It got real big. And then we had Easter dinner. And we was eating this red soup. And it had all this shredded meat inside of it. H-A-R-E. And my mom was asking everybody, did they love the soup? And we all were saying we love the soup. So my mom had a guest at the table who was eating with us. If I'm not mistaken, I think it was, at the time, it was my brother's dad, but he had passed away before my brother was born. But he was eating at the table with us. And he told my mom that the rabbit soup was good. And I was like, what? What's in the soup? And my mom said, rabbit. So we started looking around for our rabbit. And one of my my sister started screaming, and I realized that the soup that she cooked was our rabbit, child. I threw up all over the place. It wouldn't stop coming out. I threw up so bad. My mother left me from the table to whoop my tail, and I still was throwing up. Even while she grabbed me from the table, she traumatized me, okay? So I don't eat rabbit. I don't try to eat rabbit. I don't taste rabbit. I had rabbit one time in my life. I was really tearing it up, eating it too. I didn't even thought it was chicken. That's what I thought as a little girl. My mother gave us a rabbit, let us raise it, and then cooked it for Easter. She did. She traumatized us, y'all. And you know, we was never really allowed to talk about it. We, like, whatever she did to us, it was like, to bring it up is disrespecting her. So we couldn't disrespect her by bringing up the fact she cooked our freaking pet. Like, my mom cooked my freaking pet, okay? I can't find it. H-A-R-E. And I remember when we got it, we were so happy. I started feeling like, wow, like, all the crazy stuff my mother did. Maybe, you know, she wasn't so bad. Maybe she did really love me, and she wanted me to have a pet. That's how I was feeling. Not, she gave me a freaking pet to babysit and get fat so she can cook it. And that's exactly what she did. Not that I'm mad with her, but I ain't gonna never forget it. Like, I was a little kid. I was literally maybe about, I would say 7, 8 years old. Okay, here, come on now, where you at? H-A-R-E, here. H-A-R-E. H-A-R-E, I don't see it. What am I missing? Skip that one. H-A. It's funny, but I don't even see like a A and a R next to each other. Right here, go A and a R next to each other. H A R E. H A A. H A. Okay, it may come up somehow or another. Okay, so let's move on. Hedgehog. H-E-G. Okay. Hog. I actually can't remember what a hedgehog look like. Mouse. A newt. What the freak is a newt? N-E-W-T. Fig, fig Newtons. That's all I can think of. Newton. I don't know what a newt is. is waiting around watching you, trying to steal your cheese. C-R-E-T. Hands, but his paws, like in the car, tall on top of each other like that, and yeah, his body slanted to the door, and it was just like he was sitting up there real cool, and they was going past us in slow motion, and I started screaming. You would have thought that the dog was famous, and I was like, oh my god, that is too freaking cute, a freaking hood dog. That's what he was a dog like from the hood. Oh my god, the guy had him dressed up like he was Kumo D somebody. Oh my god, it was crazy. I was like, oh my god, this is too much. I cannot handle this. Me and my daughter was cracking up afterwards because we were like, what's up. You like what you see. What's up? We was like, oh my God, this dog is too cool. Yeah, they was going to another store, but we were just like shocked. And then Nadine was like, wow, he got a good dog. The dog wasn't even trying to like get out the car or jump around or he didn't even have his tongue out. You know how the dogs be like, with their tongue out. No, he was sitting up there cool, cool G. He was so cool. You couldn't tell him nothing. Okay, toad, T-O-A-D. T, oh, I keep coming back to this right here, but it ain't that. T-O-G. T-O. This part is so empty, like something got to be down here. There you go. Toad. All right, here. Maybe here is down here too. Piece of candy, love.